guys, I'm Michael Cheek, MikesGuitarLessons.com. This is the fourth video, I believe, for 21 Guns by Green Day. We're going to start the solo here. All right. Now, the solo starts at about 3:16 into the song, 3 minutes, 16 seconds. And I'm going to play along with it here in a minute. But I'm going to show you some of it first, okay? Now, what we're going to do is start off with sliding a note on the A string up to the 8th fret. Now, where you start doesn't really matter. To be honest, you don't even have to slide it. Most of the time, because I'm coming right out of the power chords, I don't slide my finger. But you can if you want to. Now, you're going to start off on the 8th fret of the A string. Oh, turn my volume up. 8th fret of the A string to 10th fret on the D string. And the fingers I'm using, just a quick note, are the ones I like to use. And sometimes I change them up a little bit. So just use what's ever comfortable, just as long as you get the notes played. It's really okay on this one, okay? So again, 8th on the A, 10th fret on the D. Then we're going to go 10th fret on the B string. Then 10th fret on the G string. Then 12th fret on the G. Back to 10th on the B string. Then to 10th fret on the G string. Now that's kind of a long note, so I always like to vibrato that one. And that's the first section of the solo, okay? So again. Here's the second section, 12th fret on the D string, 10th fret on the G, back to 12th fret on the D, 9 on the G string, 10 on the G, 12th fret on the D string. And that's the end of the second section. So. First 2 seconds together. There we go. Now, here's the third section. 8th fret on the D string. 7th fret on the G. Back to 8th on the D. Back to 7th on the G. Then 5th fret on the G. 2nd fret on the G, 3rd fret on the D, 3rd fret on the D again, and then a quick 2nd fret on the G string. What you're really doing is playing that note just so you can slide it up to the 9th fret. So, okay, so now that we're at the 9th, we're going to play the 9th fret 2 more times. 10th fret on the G string, and then 12th fret on the G string. Okay? So again, the third section is. You're going to play what I just played 2 times in a row. Okay? So basically, everything that I just showed you, play it all one more time. And then we get to the last section of the solo. Okay? So the last section of the solo goes like this. Okay? Seems real familiar, right? going to be 8th fret on the D string, 7th on the G, back to 8th on the D, back to 7th on the G, then 5th fret on the G, and then 2nd fret on the G, and then 3rd fret on the D string twice, then 2nd fret real quick on the G string, sliding up to 9th fret on the G. But this time, you just play 3 more times on the G string, 9th fret. Okay? So that last section is... Okay? And then after that, you just kind of end it out of the verse. Then you've got the chorus. But basically, that's it. The last time you go into the chorus, you leave out that intro power chord that you have other times you play the chorus. But other than that, that's the rest of the song. So what I'm going to do here is do my best not to screw this up and play along with the solo. Okay? So here we go. Again, this is about a minute, 3:16 into the song. I'm starting this at 3:13, so I've got time to get ready for it. But this happens right after the bridge. So here we go. Solos, it's good to remember just quickly that it's better to play the solo slowly at the beginning with all your rhythms correctly, playing all your notes perfectly, and then start to speed it up a little bit. So get your notes written down that I taught you, play it slowly, and then start to speed it up without messing up. If you start messing up too much, try slowing it back down, and then getting it good, getting it down cold, and then moving it up faster again, okay? It's a great song. It's not too hard. It sounds good. It's catchy. And real popular right now. So if you've got any questions, you know, you can email me at feedback@mikesguitarlessons.com. If not, thanks for watching and good luck.